She's going to tell us how the Lord has been a blessing in her life. Amen.
Praise God. Give it unto God, Pastor Sister Hill, and all the other ministers here today, and all my brothers and sisters. I'm going to try to be fast and brief. But you know, sometimes we just have to tell our testimony so other people can realize how God can truly bless. On last Sunday, was the last Sunday Pastor Hill was talking about the monies, and we was expecting something to come through, my husband and I, and me and him looked at each other. We still went on and gave an offering, and but we just, anyway. So what happened was, you know how the word says that people give up into your bosom?
Yes.
And I'm finding out that God literally means that. We had a property, my husband and I, and it seemed like every time we get somebody in that property, they would just tear it up. I mean, literally, last time we worked on it, looked like they was throwing each other in the walls. I mean, literally. We had to do so much repairs. And we really was tired of replacing stuff on the outside, and so we was fixing it up, trying to get it decent. We wanted to get it covered, you know, with siding, so it would really look nice. But every time somebody get, they tear up on the inside, so we just spend more money. Anyway, somebody called me. I had called this person actually in reference to someone else a few months ago. Well, they called me. I didn't even know who it was. And he all of a sudden decided he wanted to buy a property that I had, which was that one. And so he asked me, well, how much do you want for the property? And so I said, well, how much are you offering? Which was a good idea. Because he offered me way more than what it was worth. First of all, it was the smallest property I have. It's 2-bedroom. But it's kind of big because it has a large den. But most people want at least a 3-bedroom. So we really kind of knew it was something we kind of need to get rid of. And so anyway, I was like, okay. But I had to think about it. I still didn't talk to my husband. So I said, you know, we'll talk about it. Yes, he agreed. He's like, baby, yep. So you know something, a little something. But it's best to have your sisters and brothers help you. So we have two people in the ministry that are in real estate. And they told me, jump, girl, jump. Okay, so, all right. So we really prayed about it, and we really wanted to be a blessing to the ministry. And the gentleman wanted to see it. He said, well, we agreed on the price. He said, well, I'm going to talk to the purse strings. So he talked to them, and he came and actually looked in the house. Like I said, we had redone it and everything. And I still thought he going to say, oh, no, it's not worth it, because it's our oldest property, actually. No, he didn't blink an eye, nothing. He go, it's a little older. But yeah, we're going to go with that. So God blessed us. We went to everything went out. It took a little time, a little extra, little here and there, but we did it. And so I went to the bank the other day. We had this new little girl that's at the bank, and so she kind of looked at the check, and then she was like, she went to the back, and so she talked to the other people more experienced than her, and they looked it up, and so they said, yeah, we got it. And so she came on back, and I said, well, how many days are they gonna hold the check? She said, honey, you've been here so long, they said, we're going to get your money to release today. And I was like, thank you, Lord, because I wanted to be able to get my tithes today. And so they did that for me. And it's amazing, because somehow I mentioned what it was for. She was looking for a property. And I have a property that came available, so I might have a new tenant, and one that got a job, and one that'll pay the rent. But, you know, I just want to say one more thing. I was talking to my daughter. I'm just going to say who it was. And she said, Mama, you know, maybe you shouldn't be telling people stuff like that because they'll think you're bragging. And I said, well, you know, I think that's more about them than it is me. But it still kind of vexed me a little bit in my spirit because I don't want to be over boisterous or like I'm all that in a bag of chips. Because every time I tell people about my testimony of anything God has blessed me, I said, he can do great. He don't have to respect the person. He can do great than you can think or ask for you. He can do more than you than he did for me. So I went home and I still asked my husband about it. He said, baby, you share about prosperity, but no more than you share about salvation. He said, and some people never get what we've been taught. So they never know. They continue to walk in lack because they don't know. They haven't gotten the word. He said, so no, I don't think that's true. And I know if you have a desire, because me and my husband, I thank God, we're both in agreement. When I married him, he already knew about tithes. I didn't have to prim and prod him about we need to have tithes. And it's getting so good, we'll look at each other and almost know exactly how much money we're supposed to give at the same time. So I'm grateful for what I got here and what God is doing to our lives. Amen, amen, amen. Amen.
Among the people. Hallelujah. My boss is in the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay. All right. God bless you. bless your sister already. Amen. It already has. That's why it's hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Amen. So he takes pleasure in your prosperity. This is good, good, good will to give you the keys to the kingdom.
And, it's amazing because somehow I mentioned what it was for. She was looking for a property. And I have a property that came available. So I might have a new tenant and one that got a job and one that'll pay the rent. But, you know, I just want to say one more thing. I was talking to my daughter. I'm just going to say who it was. And she said, Mama, you know, maybe you shouldn't be telling people stuff like that because they'll think you're bragging. And I said, well, you know, I think that's more about them than it is me. But it still kind of vexed me a little bit in my spirit because I don't want to be over boisterous or like I'm all that in a bag of chips. Because every time I tell people about my testimony of anything God's blessing, I said, he can do great. He don't have to respect the person. He can do greater than you can think or ask for you. He can do more than you than he did for me. So I went home and I still asked my husband about it. He said, baby.